on the Marvel side. This is not the game. We're talking about Marvel and Capcom. Starting with Marvel, it's been a great franchise for however many, like 30, 40 years, until Spider-Man 3. Capcom?
On Capcom's side, it's been a decent game coming up, not major titles, but there's one thing I have one complaint about. A series of Mega Man games. There's 9. There's Insane 9. All the spin-offs are getting weird. And whatever happens, just Dr. Light, save the world, fight the robots, beat the game.
It should only be number sequels from now on. No, Mega Man X, no Mega Man X9, no Mega Man
Zero.
No Mega Man Zero.
Mm-hmm. Just straight sequels after another.
And on the Marvel side, shitty games except for X-Men Origins, Wolverine, and Marvel vs. Capcom.
Marvel Ultimate Alliance is good.
I didn't like, no, I didn't play.
They are good. Okay, character-wise.
No more dragons!
Okay, character-wise, we're getting tired of spin-offs of other characters.
Especially Network Transmission, which isn't really a spin-off. We just don't like it.
I'm getting tired of like certain characters, like the Fantastic Four. I'm tired of them. You know why? They don't do anything epic. They fight one person.
They fight one epic person?
Okay, they fight one person over and over again. They never beat said person, they fight that person over and over again.
But then again, on characters, we're all tired of Spider-Man, aren't we?
We are all tired of Spider-Man.
We are all tired of Spider-Man.
I am also tired of Wolverine. He is not that worthy of being a superhero. He's a genetic freak who drew claws. That's it.
What about Storm? What if Storm had her own Origins movie?
Hell, if Storm had her own Origins movie, it would be completely in Africa.
Exactly, she was an African goddess.
Because, you know what? Storm's a fine character, she knows what she's doing. She's not a complete, utter fucking dick with the powers.
All hail Storm!
Okay, now on the Marvel side, when we talk about comics, we're talking about decades of classic comics, but then we get to Marvel Civil War, which was the most epic series of all, except for Spider-Man taking off his mask and putting it back on, but nobody even remembers who the hell he was.
And I gotta remember, the whole Spider-Man storyline, it's kind of bull how he got his powers. Okay, I'm a guy, I'm a big loser. I get bit by a radioactive spider.
Cancer!
Cancer happens. You die. End of series. That's it.
Spider-Man.
Goes to chemo on a daily basis. Okay, now gonna move on to the X-Men.
Charles Xavier dies, and Cyclops takes over in the comic book, which is pretty decent. Charles Xavier dies. Nobody really takes over in the movie.
The reason why the Phoenix is a powerful character is because you rarely see her. When you rarely see things, they're rarely awesome. Let's say, a good Capcom game involving Resident Evil? That's few and far between.
Oh, come on, Resident Evil 4 kicked ass. Resident Evil 2, 3, and 4 were awesome. 1 and 5 suck.
Exactly, they're few and far between.
And then there's the Dark Side Chronicles coming out for the Nintendo Wii.
Do not buy that. Now granted, you want to buy a good game with glitter money? Buy games from Nintendo. There's your orange.
You don't just go out buying anything but for the Nintendo Wii. Get something with either Wii or Nintendo in the title.
Don't buy any more of the peripheral games. They're starting to get old, and they're starting to lean on it like a crutch.
Dragon Blade, sir. Sir, my sir, Dragon Blade. That is the best game for. That's one of the best games for the
Wii. If you buy Ninja Reflexes, it doesn't make you a ninja. It makes you retarded.
It's so false. I gotta admit, even I own a Wii, and I'm getting tired of all the dazzle sparkly motion controls.
You know what? When Nintendo was playing awful was the fact that we're bringing something new, hopefully people will like it. They had a good run for a while, but they needed to make it a record console with controllers and systems. based on fun games. Granted, they're not the greatest graphical company, but I figure if you have a shit game that looks awesome, but the gameplay makes you want to run into a wall over and over again until your character dies, you're pretty much done.
The thing about the Nintendo Wii is that game companies are trying to build graphics into the game using the exact same engine that they used for the PS3 and 360. The Wii is built differently, so you have to build a different graphics engine to fit the Wii specifications. Don't try to make it look as good as possible using the 360s and PS3. Same freaking process of making the graphics with polygons and everything. Build it from the ground up using the Wii's limitations and storage issues. I know you can do it.
Okay, we're introducing a new series of games into the Wii, Monster Hunter. Granted, it existed on the PS2, the PSP, and there's some PC title. It's a fun game. Play it, you'll love it. Granted, it's not a whole level-based game where like you kill a monster, you level up. No, it's about fighting monsters, gathering material, making new weapons, fighting bigger monsters, and overall achieving a goal of saving your village. I've never read Marvel comics.
I have.
That's what makes this a balanced debate.
I'm a Marvel.
I'm a Capcom. That was retarded.
Live long and prosper.
Alright. This has been Mega Man 66.
And Wonder Bread.
And this is the anger. Boomer.
And cut.
No. Of game companies that gotta stop making games. Sega, you gotta stop pouring out Sonic. There's too many Sonic games, none of them are good, and if you're gonna bring back a Sonic franchise, at least make it with decent games. Like, and come on, what was the idea behind the Werehog? Like, why? If you're gonna bring out a decent character, at least introduce somebody new. A Tails Chronicle, a Knuckles Saga, bring back the Chaotix, what are you gonna do? Now we're gonna move on to Turok. That game was great. It had
beans.
It had beans.
I'm so sorry.
So now we're moving on. Now that we've seen Turok, Revolution, another bean.
I am so sorry.
Now we're gonna move on to another game series.
Don't interfere.
We're gonna bring up. Sorry, that took a little longer. Now, Super Smash Bros. Is a game made by Nintendo. It came out on the original N64. It was great. It had up to like 8 or 9 characters. That was awesome. Now we're gonna move on to Melee, the greatest game in the series. It was the funnest. It had the best. A decent amount of characters, overpowered moves. It was fun as hell.
But it got rid of the bumper.
Now we're gonna move into Brawl. That game was fun. They could have gotten rid of two things to make it great. Get rid of the Subspace Emissary and get rid of the trophy and sticker items.
Just the stickers.
Stickers gone, you're able to move a lot more rooms, skip the board, boss 2-3 more characters, put back characters we love. Mewtwo, Roy, and I'd say Mewtwo, Roy, and
Kid.
Well, Kid Link and Tunic are basically the same, it's just shell-shaped.
He's doing the angry, isn't he?
Now, when we conclude this rant, I want to say that I am tired of Metal Gear. It's fun, it's over, Snake should die. We're done.